Hi everybody, welcome to another episode of Fish Keeping Jamaica. Today I am showing you my 45 gallon barrel pond. It has a window in it and it's all set up, but the aesthetics of it has not yet been completed. The emphasis of today's video is to actually emphasize some of the dynamics of this and possible areas in which changes are needed. Okay, the purpose of this barrel pond is so that you can actually view your fish. Presently, my Oscar is within the pond. As you can see, he's acting as if he's all that shy. Okay, the third thing you must notice is that the screws are looking as if they are getting rusty. So I'm going to have to deal with that issue. How I will deal with that issue, I will be purchasing a primer spray in which I will actually cover here with paper, right, and cover powder here with paper, and then I'll be spraying probably about 1/2 inch of this primer spray both on the outside and on the inside. What this primer spray does, similar to when you paint a grill, it will actually sit on the screw and it will prevent the air, which has oxygen, from oxidizing with the iron that exists within the metal. Okay, I found it very difficult to actually get the screws that were not rust proof. Okay, so let's get in the meat of the matter. Meanwhile, my Oscar is there wondering what I'm doing. Okay, so the pond is not properly seated, right? What will happen is that during the course of next week, I'll be actually excavating this section of the garden, wherein which I will actually get it to be flat. As you can see, the water level in the pond, you can see where it is, it's tilting towards that section, which suggests that the water is not level. The pond itself is not level. Okay, so I purchased, for this specific pond, I purchased a 120 gallon pump. Now this 120 gallon pump was purchased purposefully, although it is a 45 gallon container. It is expected that the fish that will exist in this pond will be able to be comfortable, and the waste will be filtered very easily. However, I realized that my overflow, which is here, is incorrectly placed. So what I'm going to be doing, I'm going to allow this to stay, but I'm also going to be putting one right here. It's an overflow pipe, should in case rainfall. And when I'm going to excavate that section, but I'm going to explain to you the reason why this is at the incorrect place. Right? When rainfall, the water, the overflow water, will actually escapes and go into the garden. Okay, so here comes with the main features in which I know that you want to me to explain. Now the pump is 120 gallon. That means for every hour it pumps 120 gallon upward, well, through a system. Right? Now this system is built uniquely. I try my very best so as to facilitate bio and mechanical filtration. Now what I do, I actually place some fiber here. Already the Oscar have started to release some waste in which you can actually see it within the fiber. Right, what happened is that here you have a piece of PVC pipe. This is about probably about six inches in length, right? It has some fine holes in it. What happens is that the water actually comes from the base here. It's about 3/4 inches in thickness, right? It is held, the pipe is held in position by a bulkhead. Is then connected to a female adapter, and this is a reducer. And this is a 1/2 inch pipe. An elbow is then placed here, which actually turns the water channel upward, and because I had to adjust it because it was too long, I had to cut it and then adjust it so that it can actually flush within here. Now the water travels from down below here, it comes all the way up here, right, goes through the middle of this container here, comes up through the middle here, right, through several fine holes, and this fiber, the water goes through this fiber, right, and the whatever is there to be held is held by the fiber. Water pushes up and it rises, and heavy waste actually sits here. Heavy waste actually sits here because as the water flow up, by the way, this container is about an inch lower than the top of this. It's purpose done, because as the water rises here, what will happen is that they are fine, by the way, they are very fine holes in this container, very fine holes, right? So water is coming through all different sections, not only at the top, right? Water is coming through this, it goes through the fiber, and from the fiber it goes through this container, which have several drain holes, as you had seen in the production of this filtration system. The purpose why the water actually, why I allow the water to go through it, is because I want water to be both mechanically and biologically filtered. The mechanical filtration is this, while the biological filtration is the gravel that is at the side. What happens is that the bacteria, beneficial bacteria, will actually stay on the surface of these rocks and will multiply, and water will actually circulate by going back through this bulkhead, which enters back into the container. Now this will continue, and I have to ensure that right here is kept clear so as to not allow for water to actually rise over. Now if I identify several issues with this container, so I'll be using the same mechanism, however I'll be using a larger container so as to allow this container, well, to allow this filter box to be a little taller than here, about here, right? It's supposed to be tall like this, and the reason why is that if rain do fall and it's very heavy, before it actually reaches the level for this overflow to actually take out the water, the excess water will actually backflow into this filtration system and actually flood this filter. So what I will need to do, I need to actually bring this up a little bit more, probably get a larger container so as not to trouble here. So the larger container will be about here, so therefore even if rain fall and this is covered in water, which actually help the water to escape without actually resulting in the fish going on the outside, this will be okay. This would not be flooding, right? The emphasis here is to allow for circulation and prevent leakage and to manage the waste within the pond, right? Now this filtration system do works, and point to note, the water is being filtered by this pump, right? This pump is attached to a flexible hose. The reason why this pump is attached to a flexible hose is that at any time, should in case I have actually identified areas in which needs to be filtered more, because this pump actually takes up the water, right, through here. It takes up the water and it feeds it through the filtration system. Now if I decide that over here need a little bit more, you know, water needs to be sucked up a little bit, I can easily just tilt the hose that is there, that's flexible, over to that section, and I will take up that waste. Now my Oscar original pond is being cleaned, so therefore it will stay in this pond for about a week. Okay, now you might be wondering, what about these screws? Won't these screws actually hurt the fish? Well, no. What will happen is that these screws are all have silicones on them,
and it, as you as I rub my hand on it, I can actually feel the conditioner in the pond, where it's really slimy, right? So therefore, bouncing on these would be just like bouncing on any decoration within the pond, right? So it's not that pointed, it's not sharp, and it won't damage the fish. By the way, large fish such as my Oscar will not be in this pond. I intend to make this a nano pond. So therefore, I will be getting some dinos. I'll be getting some probably a few tiger barbs and some other small fish to place in it. I will be doing some aquascaping, right? Some hardscape and aquascaping, putting in some plants, and I will show you as I get along, right? But this video is primarily to show you how this system actually works. Now, with probably about 15 nano fish in this, it should do wonderful, right? Much water change is not really needed, probably about once every 2 weeks, and it should be okay, because I'll be having some plants in this system which will negate the fact that I need to do regular water change. Now, the pump is actually turned down very low, because whenever it's too high, what will happen is that the filter itself will actually flood. So that's one of the reasons. Let's look at it. Right, let's look at it. When I turn the pump a little bit harder on, yeah, you'll notice that the pump itself is flowing a little bit more harder. Why is it? It won't overflow, but the simplest of a rainfall, as I realized the other day, will cause a lot of water to be coming up very much to the top, which is a cause of concern to me, should in case, let's say, no one is here and the system is on and the fish is there, and you notice the pump is actually at the base of the pond. We have mechanisms on the base in which it can actually be stuck to the floor of the pond. We have some sticky, I don't know what you would call those, really. But it will be there. So the fish should be okay, because it is too much at the edge. And this is one of the reasons why I think that the container should be a little bit bigger. As you notice, why is it not overflowing? Because it's actually returning back into this return pipe. I think that if the container was a little bit higher, this problem wouldn't be there. So I'm going to be changing this, but I'm going to be doing other work on this pond before I actually take steps to do that, right? And as I turned up the pump, you notice that the flow of the water have actually increased. Now I'm going to be turning it back down. I'm going to be turning it down so it won't be of an issue, should in case I forget. And my wife will say that I am a very forgetful individual. So I am trying to turn this pump down. So there it is, it's down. The hose fell out, so I am actually trying to fit the hose back into the pump. Yeah. I have not fed my fish, and for those persons who are might be wondering why is it that I keep feeding my fish after I've done water change. This is a habit of mine, because I believe that whenever I do water change, it's a sense of a clean environment. You never eat in a dirty plate, so I try to have my fish adopt that same principle. So this will be here, and I will put this in two lights, not to go against my philosophy, the whole idea of lights, but just for walkway lights. Be placed probably somewhere here, right? So the pond itself will be highlighted, and the fish will be okay, right? The hose, I just realized that the hose fell out of the section in which it should be, so I'm gonna be replacing it. Oscar measures probably about 9 inches,
And I like the idea of this glass one, because I'm able now to actually see my fish. Instead of seeing it at the top, I can now see it at the side. My ideal garden barrel pond is not yet done. What I intend to do at the probably about a few weeks time, after I've asked aquascape and I've actually hardscape the inside of the pond, intend to get some flowers, probably some of my wife's flowers, right? And I'll be placing it around the pond itself. And one of the reasons why I have not gone about to actually decorate the outside is because I intend to use plants to place all around it, right? And plants will be inside of it along with some little fancy stuff, in which it should make the appearance of this pond simple, neat, but creative. It is hope that you understand the concept of this, which is creativity and the whole idea of sharing an idea. By the way, the wind pond issue is not a new phenomenon in the fish keeping hobby. I've seen it, but the whole construction of it have not been actually highlighted. So I just took it at liberty to do so. Thank you for making me fish keep in Jamaica. I hope that this video will be of interest to you, and I hope that you can probably use a section of this mechanism so as to improve your fish keeping hobby. Thank you very much. Bye bye from Raleigh.